What's up, guys, and welcome back to Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 2. And today we're going to be doing our first ever top 5 classes video. It's going to be a little bit different, but basically today I'm going to be going over my top 5 favorite kernel corns, which is a pretty easy choice to make because there's only 6 kernel corns in total. But I'll be talking about that in just a second. First, I want to go over how I'll be doing this. Since I have mastered every single kernel corn, I feel like I have the right to tell you which ones are my favorite and which ones aren't. But when it comes to characters where I don't have everything mastered, I'm going to wait until I master them. So if I master all of the chompers, then I'll probably make a top 5 chompers video. Now, I just don't want to, you know, sit here and list them off because I feel like that would be boring. Instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to play 5 rounds of team deathmatch or something similar, and with each round, I'm going to play like my 5th most favorite kernel corn, then my 4th, 3rd, 2nd, and then finally my 1st most favorite kernel corn. That way we're sort of moving along, and while I'm playing those characters, I'll talk about why I like them as much as I do, their strengths, you know, their weaknesses, all that kind of stuff, and that is the goal. So I hope you guys enjoy this, and if you do, we'll do it for all the other class types once I master all of them. But yeah, I feel like it's a fun way to do the top 5s while still being able to play the game as some of these awesome characters. So with that being said, let's go ahead and get started with my first ever top 5 characters with the top 5 Kernel Corns. So my number 5 character out of my top 5 Kernel Corns has to be the Mob Cob. Now, it was between the Mob Cob and the Party Corn for me, and before anybody gets mad, I don't think the Mob Cob or the Party Corn are bad characters. Just because they are farther down the list doesn't make them bad characters, it just means that the other characters in comparison might be a little better for one reason or another, and at the end of the day, it's always personal preference. You might be the biggest, you know, best Mob Cop player of all time, and to you, you know, Mob Cop might be awesome, and that is awesome for you, and I'm glad, you know, that's the case. But for me, I've never really been a big fan of the Mob Cop's playstyle. He's sort of like a mid to low range Kernel Corn, and a lot of times that's just sort of awkward with how I play the Kernel Corn. The Kernel Corn's supposed to be able to jump around and be mobile, and it's hard to do that if you're focused on this mid range presence. And as you know, while I'm talking about this, I'm doing really well, but, why the Mob Cob has that mid to low range presence is because he can shoot through enemies. So if there is somebody like behind the person you're shooting, they will also take damage. I know in other games they call that a collateral damage. So that's really the whole idea with the Mob Cob. It's just sort of because of that, I feel like his shot is a little less accurate. It is really hard to keep, you know, a good hold on the enemy players, and that can be a little bit frustrating. He can be nice taking out bigger targets like the Super Brains from what I've noticed, but overall he's still a struggle. Soldiers and imps usually just circle around me forever whenever I'm playing the Mob Cob, and it's just super hard to keep up with. He really just doesn't fit the ideal playstyle I think a Kernel Corn can benefit from, and that's sort of my big gripe with him. He's still a fun character overall because he's a stinking Kernel Corn. The Kernel Corn's moveset in general is a really great one in my opinion. You know, the Husk Hop, the Shark Shot, and the other forms of butter, they're all really good. Hi, Stern. Bye, Stern. So at the end of the day, I don't think the Mob Cob's a bad character. I just think he is the least awesome out of a set of very good characters, at least out of the top 5. Why I think the Party Corn is in number 6 is a whole different discussion. And I think it has to do more with the fact that I don't really like how party characters work, more than it does that the party character is a bad character. I think that also the party character got nerfed at some point, and he just really hasn't recovered since then. He's sort of like a, you know, like sort of like a, I wanna say a discount Kernel Corn, but he's just, I feel like he's just not as good as the base Kernel Corn, and that's sort of an issue. And that's really because of how party time works. Like, I think he does have slightly worse stats than the normal Kernel Corn, but also it's like trying to earn up that party time is usually frustrating just because of how party time works. You know, if you get vanquished, all of your party time is gone. You have to essentially try to steal vanquishes from your teammates to be able to get party time. And that's sort of something you'll hear from me a lot when judging characters for these top 5s, especially when there's only 6 characters to choose from. One of them has to be left out, and for me it has to be the Party Corn. So now you know my number 6 as well, which of course is pretty easy to figure out. But yeah, that's why Mob Cob is number 5. I do think the Mob Cob is more fun to play than the Party Corn. He, like I said, and he's not unfun to play, but when it comes to, you know, trying to do well with characters, he wouldn't be my first Kernel Corn of choice, obviously. But with that being said, we're not doing too bad this round. There have definitely been worse rounds I have had with the Mob Cob. He's a tough one for sure. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. And like I said before, just because he's number 5 doesn't mean he's a bad character. I think that my number 4 pick is a really, really great character. I love him a lot. But It's just, there's other characters that are near and dear to my heart just because I can play with them even better, and I have even more enjoyment out of them. There's no really bad choice. And also, you know, since this is the beginning of our top five series like this, I want to do more for sure, but of course, I want to know if you guys, what you think about this method, this kind of video. Not only that, but let me know your top fives. Like, what is your top five Kernel Corns? I would love to hear in the comments section. Especially since I'm running out of things to say about Mob Cop. This guy's running away. And like, even there, like, I just feel like my accuracy is a little weird. And that's sort of the thing about the Mob Cop you want to have, is point blank range. That's sort of the thing that I have found benefits the Mob Cop the most. But you know, it can be a little rough. Are there still zombies up here? Okay, who's attacking me right now? This scientist really doesn't like me. And that's sort of, if you're going against a Mob Cop, dodging and weaving is probably one of your best bets. Trying to be as mobile and circling around people as possible, that's really what you want to get accomplished. I can't believe I got a vanquish out of that shuck shot, by the way. And there we go, it looks like the plants won here. We didn't do too bad as the Mob Cop. But yep, number five coming in with the Mob Cop. And number four has to be the Popscorn. Now, Popscorn is near and dear to my heart. I always like to call him Popcorn because that's just more fun and easier for me to say for whatever reason. And people get really mad at me because of that. I don't know why. If you're one of those people, let me know why. But I love the Popscorn so much. I love his style of gameplay. If you don't know, he has the triple shot, you know, similar to the Super Commando Soldier or the Citrus Cactus in Garden Warfare 1. He has that one press equals triple shot. It's so much fun when you are on your A game with this guy. I remember leveling up to level 10 was actually one of my favorite experiences leveling up a character, because once you get the damage upgrades on this guy, he is scary. Oh boy. Okay, come on, come on, come on. Ready? Bada bing! There you go. He is really scary. If you can get used to landing headshots with the Popscorn, getting that triple, like 12 damage each, like you can melt the zombies. It's insane. But that's sort of where the big issue comes. The Popscorn is a lot of fun to play, but in my opinion, you really have to be in practice with them to get really good with them. And if you're, you know, end up playing other Kernel Corns, you sort of fall out of practice. So to enjoy the Popscorn, you almost have to play him exclusively at times. Or at least that's how I found it for the most part, because he's almost like the perfect bridge between a Kernel Corn and a sniper, which is really cool. I'm sure you could make a better link between a Kernel Corn and a sniper, but currently he's the best we've got and it's a lot of fun. It really, really is. So I'm gonna hop over here because everybody's trying to hurt me and I don't like it when my feelings are hurt. How did that not get him? I don't know. Everyone was beating me up there. And of course, he plays a lot more similarly to normal Kernel Corns than the Mob Cop does. And I really enjoy playing this Kernel Corn, but it's one of those things, like I said, he's one of the more difficult to master Kernel Corns at first, in my opinion. Of course, it depends on your playstyle for you for sure, but that's always how I felt about him. He is an absolute blast though. Getting into level 10 was so much fun, especially when I finally got those proper damage upgrades. Next time I die, I'll try to show you what my character upgrades are on him, because I feel like he's one of those few characters that, like, he's all right without the character upgrades, but once you get the character upgrades, he is a premier class. So I feel like also playing up to that point can be a bit of a struggle at times, but you know, if you can get used to him, there's some awesome fun to be had. Let's go ahead. Oh, no, you're down. Never mind. Oh geez, who's getting me here? Who's trying to get me? I'm gonna throw some butter down, some buttery havoc is about to happen. Ooh, oh, he doesn't even know. He doesn't even know. He didn't even piece it together. Oh geez, where are you going? Where are you going? See ya. Oh gosh, Kernel Corns in general are so much stinking fun. Yeah, you know, Popscorn is their number four. He's a really great class though. Like, I know I've been stressing it a lot just because I'm nervous people are gonna get the wrong opinion, but none of the Kernel Corns are bad in my opinion. There are some that are significantly better than the others, though. So let's go ahead and try to get you like that. Get you like this if I can. Oh, geez. Oh, darn it, I couldn't get him. I tried to, but I couldn't. But yeah, also something I haven't noticed, or not noticed, mentioned, is that on the top right, you can click the little I button and it can show you cards. I'll be linking all of the extensive character showcases I've done on all these top five Kernel Corns up there. So if you want to see more gameplay of the Popscorn, or the Kernel Corn, or the Mob Cop, or any other Kernel Corn I talk about or show off today, click that little I button on the top right and you can find a longer, more detailed character showcase of that character. Because I have showcased every character I currently have unlocked in the game. Not only that, but if the cards aren't working for you, because I know sometimes they don't work for people, check the comments section, because I'll be linking them there as well. Because sometimes people are like, hey, you should show off the Popscorn. I'm like, I already have. So you can go ahead and check that out, and I'll do that for all the top fives. That'll be the little method I have. because of course this gives a brief explanation on why this class is good and, you know, why I prefer it over other Kernel Corns, but it doesn't give you that full in-depth look that the showcase will give you. But there we go, number four has to be good old Papa Corn. Okay, so number three, and this is where it gets really hard to make a decision, is the BBQ Corn. Now, anybody who knows me knows that I love the BBQ Corn. He's actually one of my most played varianted characters, of course, besides base characters like the Kernel Corn. BBQ Corn is my most played. I think I have like 20 hours on this guy because I love him so much. He was one of the first characters I mastered. I was so in love with this guy when I first got him, and I still am. He's awesome, but he did go through a nerf. He was a very powerful character, and I'm not going to say that the nerf was unwarranted, but it does make it a whole lot harder for him, for me to play him, I think. Maybe it's just because it wasn't what it used to be, man. And I don't blame that on the BBQ Corn, that's just how it's changed, but I'm of course giving these characters a top five on how they currently are, not how they were, but how they currently are. Now with that being said, he's one of my favorite characters, so I hope I can play well in this round. We'll have to see. I feel like I've been playing overall pretty decently today. Well, there I go. But the BBQ Corn, you know, brings high level damage, decent range, amazing fire rate, and of course that wonderful fire damage. And before, when the game launched, and for a couple months there, he was a very, very powerful class. He was hard to go against, he was pretty easy to pick up and learn. If you know how to play the normal Kernel Corn, you knew how to play this guy, and that made it really nice. But he has been weakened. You can tell he only does so much headshot damage, it really isn't as much as it used to. But plus his, you know, fire damage and his good fire rate, he's still a good character, he just doesn't compare to the first and second slot anymore. If this was a couple months ago, back when, let me try to revive this person, if I can. But if this was a couple months ago, back when, you know, before he was nerfed, I honestly think he would have been number one. Maybe it's because, you know, I'm biased. But you know what? It's my top five list. I can be as biased as I want. But, yeah, he probably would have been number one. But he gets sort of thrown back into the mix because of the fact that he got nerfed, which is unfortunate, but you know, that's just sort of the nature of video games, right? Things change, that's life. Things change. But sometimes for the better, sometimes for the worse, it's our job. Oh gosh, bye. I thought he would have exploded by then. Lucky him. Like, I don't think he was expecting to get a vanquish with that he did. I just sort of handed that to him. But that's why my BBQ Corn friend here is number three. But he, don't get it, you know, don't get anything wrong. He's still fantastic class. As you've seen, I've already gotten seven vanquishes. It's only been like a minute or two into this round, and I'm not like really playing my best, as you can saw a moment ago when I just walked into an exploding barrel zombie that I saw a mile away. Here. Can you hold this for me? Thank you. I'm gonna put that there. I'm gonna husk hop over you if I can. Oh, no, what is, well, I'm up here now. That was weird. That was very weird. We'll get you. Okay, I helped. I don't know how I have not taken any damage for these last few moments, but I haven't. Where'd you go? You're over here now? Okay, wanna help out this fire chomper. And that fire damage is great. You know, one thing, fire classes in general are some of the best variants just because of how the fire damage works. Similar to the toxic damage, to be honest, but it's still just very, very nice. Oh boy, who can we get here? We can get you if you don't move in the wrong direction. You did, you moved in the exact opposite direction I was hoping you'd go. But it's just, it's such a great class. And also he looks really cool. I think the idea of the BBQ Corn, about how he's, you know, covered in spicy barbecue sauce and he's covered in tin foil and stuff, he's a cool aesthetic character. And that's sort of another thing I haven't mentioned too much. Like, this top five focus is mostly focused on, top five, this top five list video is mostly focused on their gameplay opposed to their aesthetic, but the aesthetic is still very cool. All the Kernel Corns have a nice touch to them. My favorite when it comes to aesthetic probably is the BBQ Corn, but the Pops Corn is very cool as well. You know what? There you go. There we go, and then let's go over here. And the thing is that with all Kernel Corns, and that's sort of a big reason why the Kernel Corn is one of my favorite variants in like classes in general, is that he has a good kit. You know, his husk hop, his shuck shot, his butter rain, I always forget what it's called for whatever reason. They are great on their own, no matter which version you are playing. It's sort of similar to the All-Star. Even if you're playing a weaker class, you can still do well because his abilities are just fantastic. And that's always something to keep in mind. So that is yet another round of Team Vanquish done. Our number three slot has to go to the BBQ Corn. So the number two slot, of course, has to go to the newest member of the Kernel Corn family, the Commando Corn. He is a fantastic legendary, an awesome aesthetic, and really tough to play. But if you can get used to him, he can be crazy powerful, and his full commando isn't that hard to get. It's sort of the thing that I wish the Party Corn was from the beginning. He's one thing really fresh to play, because he's sort of a nice mix between a Kernel Corn and Mob Cop. He's sort of what I wish the Mob Cop and Party Corn were combined, I feel like. I don't know though, it's hard to say. He's unique, he's fun, he's interesting, and he has like a different playstyle, but the more you land damage, the more it hurts. It's pretty darn nice. So good accuracy is well rewarded. There's a little bit of splash damage mixed in there, and you can see I've already gotten two vanquishes. Not that difficult, and it's gotten me most of my full commando. And I think that these right here, the other abilities, help towards my full commando. I can't really remember. I'll try my best to get full commando here, but I don't know if it'll end up working out for me. Hopefully there's somebody to revive me. But either way, this guy is so much fun to play. I had so much hype for him. Oh, thank you for trying, Chopper. I really do appreciate it. It was a nice gesture. But, he's so much fun to play. The hype behind him when Frontline Fighters released was a lot of fun as well. It was just, he's a cool character. Just like beyond, you know, how he plays, he's just cool to look at. And like I said, I'm not judging them based on what they look like. I'm judging them on how they play, but it doesn't mean I can't mention it. Let's go ahead and try to jump over that. I tried to jump over it. I actually sort of went through it, but it didn't hit me, so I'm not gonna complain. Let's go ahead and try to land this right here. It did some damage to you. Finish you off, maybe. No, wow, okay, he's moving. And I feel like I'm getting surrounded. Of course, you know, when there's at least like six or seven zombies around you, you ain't surviving no matter what class you're playing. But I feel like we did okay. And we're doing all right. Like, I'm four vanquishes in. Of course, I'm not top vanquisher. I don't feel like I'm playing the best I've ever played today, but I'm doing okay. But I really hope you guys like this way of doing top fives. Like, I know that there are other people out there who do top five characters. I mean, there's people out there who do top five everything. So it's not like I'm having some stroke of genius originality, but I thought it would be fun to mix it up by actually playing the character while talking about it and going over my top five. That way it's a little more fleshed out and I can go over a lot of the different, you know, strengths and weaknesses while showing it to you. Now, I feel like the biggest weakness with this guy, not only, you know, is just struggle to try to get him to his full commando, but he's actually a fun class to play without that full commando, to be honest with you. But it can be pretty tough to land. If you aren't well practiced with it, similar to the Popscorn, it's gonna be a bit frustrating for you. There we go. But if you can get that splash damage landing, it's pretty nice. You know, that's sort of what makes up for it. It is tough to land, but landing that splash damage is really nice against, you know, characters like the Imp, which is pretty great because I feel like the Imp is a big struggle point for the Kernel Corn. Not only is he hard to hit with your husk hop and your shark shot, he's just hard to hit in general because of how he can dodge and weave. So it's just one of those things. Let's see. I'll try to get you. Man, why do I keep on walking into the zombie spawn and thinking there won't be zombies spawning? Oh geez, where are you, sir? No, come on. But he's a blast to play. I really do enjoy myself a little bit of Commando Corn action, you know, from time to time. Landing those headshots can be tough, but it's totally worth it. I know this guy's coming around this corner. No, he turned around. He knew that I knew. He's one step ahead of the game. Let's try to get you a little bit. Come on. Since he's just showing you, he's like, huh, what's hitting me? It's not like I'm in an easy spot to get shot at. Let's get up here. And then I see you just chilling. You don't see me. I see you. Okay, that was really weird. That was really weird. It just like, it hit him and it didn't do anything. But yeah, I think that, I'm not really sure if abilities actually help your full commando. Because if so, that shows you why he's a lot better than the Party Corn. Because if that's the case, because like I said, Party Corn can only really get full or his party time by getting like legitimate vanquishes with his primary weapon. I'm pretty sure that his abilities don't count. So if I could just go ahead and try to get a shuck shot vanquish, or the game can lag out. Oh no, I got it! Look at that, it did count. So I think that really puts him like a big step ahead. I think this person has a zebra weapon, which is pretty cool. I salute you, soldier. I'm so sorry to take you out, but I'm trying to show off the full commando for my viewers. And the music for the full commando is pretty intense too. It has these really awesome drums. It's like dun, 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 dun. But I'm probably not gonna be able to show it off. But I have shown it off in the character showcase, which like I said, you can check out on the card on the top right. We're almost done. He's also like the only Kernel Corn that has hair. That's a big perk. How many Kernel Corns do you know that have hair? None of them. None of them have hair, except for him. Why, how can he grow hair? I'm not sure. I think that, well, the Chomper doesn't normally have hair, does he? He can have hair customizables. So many assists, that's good, that's good. And even taking out the mechs is pretty nice because, you know, any kind of bigger target is really nice with this guy. Because like I said, the more damage you land, the more damage you end up doing. And you can see, you can land a lot of damage. What happened there? I didn't actually shuck shot. It didn't count. Okay, whatever. Game is getting laggy now. Oh, props to that guy. Jeez, that was brutal. But while I might not be the best Commando Corn player, I don't need to be to appreciate this guy. He's fun, he's really fun. But of course, like I said before, if you guys disagree with me, I would totally love to hear your opinions in the comment section. We still have number one to get to, which we'll get into just a moment because this round is over, but the number two slot has to go to the Commando Corn for his legendary awesomeness. So finally, my number one most favorite Kernel Corn, it's probably pretty obvious at this point, is the base Kernel Corn. This guy is great. I'm gonna go ahead and clear out his customization so he doesn't look so silly, but this guy is great. I love him so much. He is a very, very well-rounded character. In all senses of the word, he's one of the most well-rounded characters in all of Garden Warfare, in my opinion. I love playing him, which means I'm gonna do awful this round, but he's just great. He's good mid-range, long-range, short-range. He works the best with his kit, even though they all work great with his kit, all of his abilities and stuff. It's just all amazing. I think he's a really good character. But I know a lot of people are probably gonna go ahead and tell me that I'm boring and that, you know, base characters shouldn't count, but I feel like they should. I feel like they're just as important as the variants and that they shouldn't matter in this, you know, kind of countdown. All right, let's try to get across to here. The chili bean will hopefully protect me and revived. Awesome stuff. Throw that over there. I'm gonna husk hop on over this guy's head. That helped a little bit, and then keep going, and then you are gonna run, so I'm gonna try to get you and miss entirely. Oh, wow, he is hopping like a little maniac. Look at him go. But geez, he's a lot of fun, and he's definitely one of those Kernel Corns that no matter what I'm doing, I can always hop on him and be able to play him without any issues. Like, I think that, like, of course, I'm not doing the best in the world right now, but I'm not doing bad, and I think that every time I play this guy, it's always been that way for me. He just sort of sits well with me, and how he controls, he's just all around, easy to pick up, easy to play, and easy to work with. And he really lays a good path for the other Kernel Corns, you know? I think that there's no problem with the other Kernel Corns resembling this base Kernel Corn in at least some kind of way. I was trying to get that person over there. But it's like, he sort of sets the track for what all the Kernel Corns should be, which is sort of this fast-paced character that's very versatile. That's what I love about the Kernel Corn, is how versatile he is. There's a lot of situations you can get yourself into and out of very well with a character like the Kernel Corn, and that's a lot of fun. I'm gonna go down here and beat up some imps if I can. Bada bing, bada boom! No, I missed. But that's okay, because I still have my very strong primary weapon. We got a 5x vanquish streak right now. But now that you know my top 5 Kernel Corns, you can tell me about how wrong I am in the comments section, and you can let me know what your favorite Kernel Corn is. There's nothing wrong with sharing your opinion, of course, but keep it civil. Keep it civil. Ooh. We all have feelings at the end of the day, isn't that right, All-Star? All right, I'm gonna wait back here. There is a mech going on. Can this land on him? Ah, barely. He wasn't even looking for it. He just sort of dodged it by accident. But chances are my next top 5 video, if you guys really enjoy this method, I don't want to like declare that I'll definitely be doing another top 5 video unless you guys let me know that, you know, you liked this video and you want to see more like it. But if I do more like this, chances are I'll probably do a top 5 imps next, because I think that's the closest set of characters I have to being mastered. I think I only need like the party imp and the pylon imp I need to master, and then once I've got those two mastered, I have every single imp mastered, which will be pretty cool. And that video is gonna be pretty complex, because not only do you have to judge the quality of the character, but their mech as well. So that's gonna be a quite complicated one to choose which one will be my top 5, but I'm sure I'll be able to get it done. Then at last, I wanted to remind people that I don't think any Kernel Corn is bad. So if your top number one favorite Kernel Corn happens to be the Party Corn, which is my least favorite out of this top 5, don't take it as an offense. It has nothing to do with what characters you like. If you are the best Party Corn player in the world, more power to you, dude. Like, you know, that's awesome. I'm glad you found a character you enjoy, and that's all that matters. That is really all that matters in this game, is that you're playing the character you like, and you have fun. But I do get a whole bunch of comments like, what is your top 5 favorite Kernel Corn? So I'm glad that I'm finally making a series like this so that you can know for yourself. All right, let's go ahead and get you, because you are not paying attention. I missed! I'm the worst! Oh, gotcha. Throw that there, and let's try to get you as much as I can, or anybody. The butter is falling out. Wait, there's two little drakes. I was getting so confused. I was trying to follow one because I thought there was only one. And I'm like, wait a minute, am I seeing double here? I was seeing double, but we're doing okay. 14 vanquishes. I can't complain about that. Now 15. Pretty nice, pretty nice. Oh boy, let's try to get you, sir. Gotcha, right at the end. I think I just won the game for our team. Very, very cool. So number one has to go to the base Kernel Corn. He's just my main man. So there you go. Now you know my top five favorite Kernel Corns. Once again, let me know in the comment section. And also check out the card on the top right if you want to see some in-depth Kernel Corn character showcases. I've showcased them all pretty extensively. They're all fantastic characters. But I wanted to do one last thing is check out my character upgrades for each one. I've usually put a lot of time in thinking about which character upgrades are best for each character, and you can let me know if yours are any different, but to give you a good idea on how much, you know, these kind of upgrades can help these characters along, and any character along, because character upgrades are very, very great, and maybe if I change up my character upgrades, I'll think entirely differently about some of these Kernel Corns, but I really like the most of them, so I can't really complain either which way. And I just have so much fun playing this guy. So I'm glad that he was my first ever top five showcase, and more are coming soon. Like I said, there more will be coming soon if you guys enjoyed this video, so make sure to show your support. And of course, if you did enjoy the video, make sure to give it a like, share it with your friends and family, and of course, comment in the comment section below. If you watched the spoiler video, make sure you comment Zebra Corn so I know you've watched it in the video and that you are a Zebratastic viewer. By the way, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.